on Rihanna's.com or whatever the site is. I just heard the song Russian's Roulette, and y'all know I don't normally do these music reviews. I just normally don't, because I'm not really a celebrity blogger, or I just don't talk about all these like celebrities or whatever, unless it's Ciara. The song in itself is very deep. It's written by Ne-Yo and produced by Ne-Yo. Ne-Yo is an excellent writer. I love his writing skills. I think the song is pretty cool. You know, it's not much to say to it. Did I expect an up-tempo? No, I didn't expect an up-tempo from Rihanna. I knew she was going to come out with a slow song, but I just did not think it was going to be something that she's already done, in a sense. I mean, the song remind me so much of Unfaithful, but Unfaithful to the extreme. Like, why do you keep talking about Adele, girl? I don't get it. Another thing that I'm kind of, like, wondering about. Why is Beyonce coming the day after her? And why is Lady Gaga coming the same day of her? Coming out the same day of her? That's kind of weird to me. It is very weird to me how all these big artists coming out in this 1 week. I don't think these gimmicks last long. Because once people get a sense that it's not really you, or once people get a sense that it's kind of boring after a while, then they don't really buy into it no more. And I can see right through it. That's not her. I mean, I like black. You know, I wear black all the time. And I don't think that I'm gothic, though. You know, my hair is black. But I don't know. I'm kind of confused. I'm very confused. But hey, the wait is over. It comes out November 23rd. So it's like, y'all, come on. All this extra stuff is really killing me. I mean, like I said, we got got bald wires all over her neck, down her throat, to my slicing, killing people, to my restroom leg, to my how she gonna kill herself, boom, pow, at the end. Then you got somebody talking about, her song is talking about a video phone, how you can watch her through it. Then you have somebody hanging themselves on their recent, latest performance with blood all over their body. All these gimmicks are back in the day. Even though I'm young, I remember them songs like "If You Love Me Like You Say You Do, Would You Show Me?" I think that's the song. But y'all know, like, songs back in the day used to have kind of some kind of substance. Now it's just slice your neck and throw it in the air. Yeah. Rihanna, good luck. I hope you sell well. I hope you really become successful with this album, because you have went through a lot this year. Just continue to keep your head up and just be. I just wish the best, and that's all I want to say. And I hope you guys have an excellent day. Peace.
Wow. I'm sitting here listening to that song. I mean, with the things that's going on in life right now, Rihanna, what was you thinking? We don't need anybody to be pulling triggers on no account. Come on, girl. Find something to sing about besides killing each other. That don't even make sense. Think about it. I was sitting up here trying to get into your new song, knowing the relationship that you and Chris Brown growing, what you all been going through, and now you're talking about pulling a trigger? We need to be trying to find out some type of song about getting back together and doing it right, not pulling a trigger. Come on, honey. The picture, what are you advertising? Are those real barbed wires wrapped around your whole body?
I don't know. I don't think so. I don't think they would do that.
Disgusting.
Do you think she's going to sell her first week?
Not with that song. I don't think so. I mean, a lot of people are into that kind of music, but me personally, pulling the trigger. Mm. No. That's kind of downgrading. No.
Okay.